Hey guys, Hobbs here. Went over my whole hard drive, found some older clips, some newer clips, and some that were really present. So I'm doing a little bit of a collage here today on different styles of the Hobbs way of pulling. This one I came across was really neat because normally I get another pally to pull half, and then I pull half, and then obviously I take over the aggro. But this time it's actually a rogue pulling, which was an amazing pull because he just vanishes. My concentration takes over. You'll see him creep away there over on the left. Now what happens, obviously, is I can even bubble and they don't go anywhere. The party that you're seeing is the same one that you saw 2 videos ago in the Scholomance video. This was actually the same day we decided to, we were on a kind of like just having a fun farming day. We decided to go here. Fortunately, at the end of this, nobody got the epic mount, which would have been awesome. These are actually a lot of guys and they hit hard, and of course, as you know from my video 2 videos ago, it's in all 70 groups, so I wasn't really worried about dying at all. You'll see everybody's full mana. It was more just a cool pull. Now this one though is more present. I've been doing a lot of the aisle dailies, not for money as I said earlier, or not for gold. It was more for reputation because I wanted to get a few items, which I'll show you at the end. This was one of my favorite dailies quests because I could do it so fast and efficiently. A lot of the dailies quests, if I'm fighting a spellcaster and they're draining your mana, it's better for me to take out my two-hander and just down them like that. Where this, I have all my Kara gear on, and of course I threw on my old Skullflame shield because it is handy with these guys. I wanted to see if it was possible too, because I had done it a few times with my Petrified Lichen Guard and also with my just regular shield that doesn't do any feedback damage, it just blocks. So there's quite a number of them on me here. And these are all orcs. I know in a while ago I had mentioned ogres, it was a slip of the tongue. A little bit about the PvP event too. I'm gonna have an updated video, guys, so for those of you who subscribed on the last video and are going to be participating, there's a poll at my wowhobs.blogspot.com showing how many horde are going to be there to defend Orgrimmar and how many alliance are going to be there to attack. So if you notice that your faction is down, spread the word on your server to get it up, so that way you'll be able to. Of course, if the alliance is higher than the horde do have an advantage having guards there and everything else to begin with. So even if the alliance is a little bit higher, but try to get it even so that way you can we can have some really good battles. I've had some nice feedback for some guilds who said that they've had a few actual guild runs that are strict PvP going, so we're gonna see some really impressive PvP, not like the my first run through. Now when you watch this, it's actually the fell armaments that I'm looking for, and I get all 5 while looting up. So I mean, that was that quick quest. I know I sped it up just while I was pulling to run. One thing you also notice, I dropped low level consecration because it's such a long run and you're not in an instance, it will run back. I drop off my quest, and this is another daily I just wanted to show, and I dinged, got my experience exalted with the Shattered Sun offensive, which it was enabled me to get this shield. I actually got the other shield as well, but I primarily use that one. I also got this necklace, which you needed to be exalted with Aldor for it to proc. So I went to the auction house, bought a bunch of stuff because I'd never really seen the need till now. If you watch my experience bar, it's not experience, I set it as reputation, but you'll see it's raising quite fast. So I'm getting that all in and exalted in 2 factions in 1 day, so that way I can show you the actual proc that happens on that necklace I got. You'll see it in the top right-hand corner. I think believe it's an 8-second thing, but it increases my dodge rating by 100, which is really cool. And I've had it in a few different. I've only had it for a few days, and it's done well. Now that I'm exalted, I got this shoulder enchant as well, which increased my dodge, and it also increased my defense as well. This week in Kara, I lost out on a few rolls to the off-tank Maze, who congrats on those. He got the pocket watch and the bracers. I ended up getting this though from Shade, which was a nice ring upgrade. Now back to this lady here in the aisle. I actually handed in 100 of my badges to get this chest piece, which, if you remember, I upgraded my chest piece a while back off of, who was it? Not Netherspite, but the other guy. I'm having a mind blank here. Nightbane. So what you're watching now is actually the first day that the Shattered Sun was on my server. Everybody was going nuts trying to get the quest started and done, both Horde and Alliance. And the reason why I'm showing this footage was my chest piece actually had a red socket. And if you remember, you had to run through Magister's Terrace to unlock the heroic mode, which you then also got a gem. I've been holding on to that gem now. I guess it's been, what, 2 months? Because this was day one of the actual expansion. And I was able to put that into my chest piece now, which helps increase spell damage, which helps hold aggro. This was a group that I'd run day one on Magister's Terrace. If you like this video, guys, rate it. Let me know. If you really like it, add to your favorites. You can add it to MySpace and all these other cool things now with YouTube. And subscribe so you'll see my next video when it comes out. Thanks again. Till next time, guys.